On this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football, Presbyterian College hosted Charleston Southern in a Big South Conference opener that came down to the wire. With no opponent this week, the Blue Hose will look to rest and recruit. We'll talk to head coach Tommy Spangler about how the Blue Hose will maximize their bye week, as well as the Charleston Southern game, highlights, injury news, plays of the week, and a whole lot more. All that ahead on this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football. Welcome to Inside Blue Hose Football. I'm your host, Ryan Rial, with the head coach of the Blue Hose, Tommy Spangler. Coach, you hosted Charleston Southern in a noon Big South Conference opener that felt like one of those old school 3 yards in a cloud of dust, you know, heavyweight counter-punching. And you came out 7-0 on the short end of it, but, I mean, what a game.
Yeah, heck of a game. And you know how people are nowadays with football. They like to see points.
Sure.
And so I hope they weren't too bored. Mm-hmm. But both defenses played outstanding. Our offense moved the ball. We just didn't finish. And I think, Ryan, what happens in a tight game like that sometimes, it comes down to three or four plays. Mm-hmm. You're not really sure when those plays are going to come.
Right.
We just didn't happen to make them, and we made some mistakes there late with a good chance to win the football game. But I felt like after the game, we were at a lot of times during the course of the game, we were the better team. Mm-hmm. We just didn't make those few plays when we needed to make it to seal the victory.
You guys made Charleston Southern do a lot of things they haven't done, turnover-wise, you know, offensive line protection-wise. But coming out of that game, you know, there's no moral victories, obviously, but how has the confidence been this week after?
Well, some people picked them to win the conference, sure. Them and Kennesaw State, who we got next, but felt good about, you know, obviously had a lot of all-conference players. We didn't have any, and I thought our kids responded, and they fought, and they battled, and we're making progress. I think since, obviously, two disappointing starters with Wake Forest and Citadel, Ryan, I think we've continued to improve each week. We've played, to this point, four playoff teams from a year ago, a bowl team from a year ago. Mm-hmm. So we've had a heck of a schedule, and our kids continue to prepare. They continue to fight. They continue to battle. We got to learn to win those close games.
Mm-hmm. Your defense forced three turnovers. They were a team that only had four coming in. You really got after them, four sacks. And then, you know, big plays from Rocky Sin, Grant Bidle. A lot of defensive guys stepped up.
Yeah, we did. And we got put in some tough situation as the game went on because we turned it over three times.
Sure.
So short fields, we held our own. We made plays when we had to make plays. We created some turnovers. I thought special teams continued to build and do some things. I thought offensively we had our moments when we take the first drive of the second half and take it down, get it in, you know, on the 3 yard line, and we spit it up and we fumbled it. So those are things we got to correct, things we can positively build on, but at the same time we got to, you know, to win those tight games, we got to figure out a way to get it done.
Sure. And you mentioned some of those offensive highlights. Let's take a look at those in the offensive highlights from the game against Charleston Southern.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Ryan, here we are on offense. We did some good things. You know, we just got to find a way to put the ball in the end zone. Here's early in the game, and Ben a little play fake inside and keeps the ball. And, you know, what was amazing on this play, he's a shoestring tackle away from maybe really breaking it a long way. And, you know, we were talking earlier, Ben's got good speed, a little bit deceptive at times, probably a little faster than what he appears to be, and was real effective on this play. And here's Ben hitting one of his favorite targets on a little shallow cross, Deshaun Davis, for a big first down. And, you know, Deshaun's had a heck of a year obviously Ben's had a productive year, and they continue to hook up. And we got to, as we wind this thing down and finish with four games, we got to keep making sure those guys are continuing to hook up. Mm-hmm. Here's number four. Here's Torrance kind of hitting a little power bounce outside and get some yardage here. Good tough running, pretty good blocking on the edge. You know, Charleston Southern's got a good defense. You know, they've been pretty stingy in all the years we've played them, and you're going to have to earn the yards you get. Mm-hmm. And that's good vision, good bounce, good lead block by Biscardi out there. Just a good overall play. Here's Ben popping it out to Deshaun in the flat, and he looks like he's hemmed up. They got him by the legs, and there he goes. You know, this was a nice drive. Unfortunately, we mm-hmm. finished the drive with a fumble. Wasn't able to punch it in. I think if you look at the final score, you think, well, offense didn't do anything. But we had our plays. We had our chances. Like I said, in these tough games, tight games, when you play good teams like Charleston Southern, you got to find a way to punch it in and win it. Here's a little inside, kind of an old school play, shuttle pass to Keith Pearson from Woodruff. Keith's a true freshman. Keith's had a heck of a year for us. Kind of rolls in there with Day-Day at the slot receiver, but kind of sets up inside where Ben's got an option to pitch it outside mm-hmm. to Torrance or pitch it underneath to Keith, and he did a good job of executing that play. And just proud of him, proud of the production he's had for us. And you know, here's offensively again. Here's Ben kind of sneaking around the edge with a good lead block right here, a good pancake, and you know, there again getting some good tough solid yards. Like I said, I know I sound a little bit like a broken record, but we got to keep finding a way to get points on the board, mm-hmm. and we'll continue to build on it.
Yeah, Coach, you mentioned Deshaun Davis and the way you guys have been consistent. Fourth game with four more receptions for him, and you see another accurate game from Ben Cheek.
No doubt. You know, Ben and Deshaun have been a tremendous connection for us all year, and obviously we've still got a few games left. Sure. We hope it continues to go, but they're exciting, you know. And not every ball is actually a long pass. It's mm-hmm. a short pass that Deshaun is – you know, just so athletic and so quick, mm-hmm. he can do something with it after he catches it.
Especially because you know the games that your freshman running backs have had, you know they're going to key on them. You're able to mix it
no
up
doubt.
With screens and draws.
And it's good to spit it out to those guys and make them do some things.
Absolutely. Yeah. Good to see that. All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll talk about our defensive highlights, special teams highlights, and you know Coach's favorite, collision of the week. That's when we return to Inside Blue Hose Football.
We're fighting cancer with caring. With technology, with knowledge, and now with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Coca-Cola, taste the feeling. And by Adidas, here to create.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Football. Coach, the broadcast team of Mike Hogwood and Ronaldo Wynn, you know, Ronaldo Wynn used to be in the NFL, played for Notre Dame, defensive guy. He was loving that game, and your defense, I mean, proved why. It was a big battle.
Well, we've gotten better, you know, in the last 2 weeks. Really proud of the guys because we gave up one touchdown against St. Francis and one against Charleston Southern, both good, pretty good offensive clubs. So our guys are buying in. They're preparing. They're executing the plan. Great job by our coaching staff, Coach Doolittle, and you know, my son, Coach Spangler, Coach Hodges, Coach Matthews, Coach Dickey, the defensive coaches are doing a good job in preparing those guys against a good Charleston Southern offense.
Absolutely. Well, let's take a look at some of those plays with the defensive highlights from the game against Charleston Southern.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Ryan, here we are on defense, and really proud of the guys' effort, and we continue to improve each and every week. K.J. Presley getting penetration. There you see from this tight shot, number 97 there at left tackle. We call that a three-technique position. He comes off the ball, gets extension, gets penetration in the backfield, tackle for loss. We had quite a few of those on the days. Had some nice sacks, caused some takeaways. Just got to keep building on it each week. Here's a nice play by Rock Yassin. His third interception on the year, continues to kind of step up, and you know, pretty good return yardage. There again, Charleston Southern's driving it a little bit, and Rock steps up and makes a big time interception in man to man coverage. And it's nice when you can kind of roll the coverage away from a guy like Rock, and he can handle it backside by himself. And got some decent blocks here and a good return. Here's a nice play by a lot of defensive guys, led by Michael Branch. But it's nice when you get a lot of blue jerseys and white helmets around the football, and you can't really tell who exactly did make that play. But it's nice to see a swarming defense and guys having fun and getting excited and knowing that they're playing a vital role in trying to win the football game. Here's Eli Turner on a blitz, a free safety off the edge, getting a big sack on the quarterback, not only a sack, but knocking the ball loose. And there's old Grant Beidle, who actually had two fumble recoveries on the day, which was big. And, you know, just another couple yards, possibly we break it, and that might be the difference in the game. But good to see excitement on the sideline and people energized. And here's Mike Fisher kind of timing up a pressure from up top coming. And we had him hemmed up. It looked like he tried to escape and get out of there, and Mike kind of tripped him up for a sack. And you know, there's two DBs with two sacks, so it's nice to see those guys get active and get involved and make some plays. Here we are kind of sniffing out a little jailbreak screen that Charleston Southern had diagnosed, and we kind of felt it. Eli Turner again gets pressure back there, and Michael Branch kind of cleans him up for a sack, almost a safety. And at the time, 2 points would have helped when it was 0-0 at this time. But good effort by our guys. Good job in coverage. Quarterback has to hold it, and we sack him. So real positive there. And then here we are again, where they play action, try to take a shot at the old true freshman Dirk Curitan, but he's there to bat it down, and they're going to keep testing Dirk. And he seems to keep stepping up and making good plays. Just real proud of him.
I mean, you know they're coming to the freshman.
Exactly. Exactly.
Just so many defensive plays, great plays from a lot of different guys. It's not just one or two. It's really everybody on that defense. All right, now let's take a look at our special teams plays from the week against Charleston Southern.
Ryan, you know, it's getting fun to watch PC play special teams, and here's some shots of our efforts on Saturday. Here's a 62-yarder by Brett Norton. I mean, he just absolutely cranked this. And, you know, talk about flipping a field. You know, when you get just a free 62-yard kick with no return, that's going to help, obviously, field position, momentum in the game, so forth. We went from, you know, thinking, hey, where's Charleston Southern going to start, to pinning them inside the 10-yard line. So a great kick, great coverage by Brett Norton there. Here we are on punt return. This was, there again, this went from maybe a 60 or so yard punt by them to Deshaun Davis going back and catching one over his shoulder, which at the time I was going, uh-oh, right. maybe a poor decision there. But then he turns what was, you know, about a 60-yard punt into only about a 35-yard net based on the return. So outstanding job by Deshaun. You know, in a 0-0 game, Ryan, every inch, every foot, every yard matters. And we're trying to grind it out and get all we can. You can see there was a couple nice blocks here for him. Good effort by our punt return team. Here we are on extra point block. They had a penalty, but you can see great penetration. Our guys aren't backing off. Great penetration. KJ Presley comes through there, almost gets a hand on it. But, you know, we did block one against St. Francis. Our guys are continuing to build on this. And before the year's out, I'm sure we're going to get another one. It's going to affect the game. But it's great effort by our guys.
Out of the five punts, three of them were longer than 50 yards. And, of course, that 62-yarder, you cannot beat that. All right, let's stick with special teams for a collision of the week.
Collision of the week is brought to you by Hannah Heating and Air.
Ryan, here's our collision of the week shot. This might be the best kickoff coverage I've seen here at PC in my 15 years. You see guys just pouring through. The guy bobbles it a little bit, but you know, when you tackle a guy inside the 10-yard line, that's outstanding coverage. And you see Rod Haygood down, Dante Boyd down, Dirk Curitan down, Colby Campbell down. You see Michael Fisher from the side. It maybe not the greatest collision, but you talk about establishing momentum to begin a game.
Coach, we'll preview the bye week in a second, but you have Kennesaw State down the road, so you know you guys can hang with a really good offense and a really good defense.
Well, I hope so. You know, like I said, we've played four teams that a year ago made the playoffs. Mm-hmm. We played Wake Forest, who's a bowl team, and then Campbell's gotten hot. They're 5-2.
Sure.
Cumberland's 5-2. So we've played a good schedule. We've played some good opponents. We've been battle tested, and we've faced a lot of the challenges. We got to just continue to keep improving, Ryan.
That sounds good. We're going to take our final break. When we come back, we're going to take a look at the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, our Coach's Corner, and look ahead to the bye week. That's when we return to Inside Blue Hose Football.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut-rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
Watching a cow.
Oh, what's it doing?
Impressions.
Power up your morning with a new 300-calorie egg white grill. Only at Chick-fil-A.
Tailgating is a song heard from Alabama to the Carolinas and everywhere in between. They say this song can be heard elsewhere, and perhaps this is true, but it is nowhere near as bright, nowhere near as loud, nowhere near as triumphant as it is in the South. Tailgating may not have been born here, but here is where tailgaters are born.
If you're considering joint replacement surgery, ask yourself these questions. Is my orthopedic surgeon experienced in joint replacement? Does he listen to my concerns? Explain all my options? Will he manage my pain? Will he help me regain the active life I want? The orthopedic surgeons of Palmetto Bone and Joint are proud members of Newberry Hospital's award-winning joint replacement team. We're among the best in the state and nation for hip and knee replacement. You have a choice. Palmetto Bone and Joint.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Hannah Heating and Air, Nichols Automotive, and by Printers Associates.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Football. And there's so much that goes on behind the scenes, the X's and O's, the tactics. Let's take a look with a coach's corner from defensive coordinator Mitch Doolittle.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. I'm Mitch Doolittle again. Glad to be here with you. Thanks for tuning in. What we're going to look at today is a strip sack by Eli Turner on a safety blitz, and then it will be recovered by Grant Beidle, our linebacker, at a critical juncture in the game. So let's watch the game tape. Okay, so what you can see here from this past Saturday is it's the second quarter. It's roughly third and nine, okay? It's tied up 0-0, as you can see, heading into halftime. We don't want to give up a score. We want to take momentum into halftime, so we need a critical stop here, be that a turnover, a field goal attempt, but we don't want to give up a touchdown. So in third and nine, we decided to bring max pressure, and what that means is we're going to blitz a total of six people and then cover with our remaining five. So what you see here is edge pressure from the free safety, Eli Turner and Nick Moss, from the top of the field. And Charleston Southern is trying to run a quarterback draw here just to stay in field goal position. So what happens is Eli Turner does a great job on his blitz path. He comes outside. Jicey Yeldale stems it inside to keep Eli free from the tackle's block or the running back's block. And then Eli sacks the quarterback, in which case causes a fumble. And Johnny on the spot, Grant Beidle, picks up the fumble with good form. And then what we're trying to do now is score. And we really want to put our offense in great field position in order to shorten that field as much as possible to give those guys a chance to score. But what I like to see here is yes, the execution on the field, but look at the sideline at the bottom. Guys are into it. Guys are excited. There's energy. There's juice. Things are really looking up here at PC, and just wish we could have made a few more plays Saturday to come away with the victory. But nonetheless, great play by Eli Turner and Grant Beidle and the other guys on D right there, and enabled us to keep it scoreless before the half. And so we're doing big things here and excited about the future. But that's this week's edition of Coach's Corner. Hope you tune in next time.
Next week's preview is brought to you by The Bud Group. Great people, smart service.
Coach, after a game like that where, you know, it's such a hard-fought, gutsy battle, coming out of the injury report, what's it looking like on Palmetto Bone and Joint?
Well, the good news, I think, you know, Joey Junius didn't play, Ryan, so I think we're going to have him back for the Kennesaw State, plus this open date gives us a little bit more time, too. We did lose Rod Haygood, and he tweaked his knee. Hope it's not too serious, has an MRI later in the week. After that, nothing, you know, some dings, dangs. Thomas Hughes kind of hurt his elbow. We're going to kind of check on that with an MRI, see how serious. I think he's going to be able to play, so nothing too unusual, just kind of normal things this time of year.
And of course, we saw, you mentioned in the highlights there, John Biscardi came in, made some good blocks, and made
he
some
did.
Plays. So you
he
guys
did.
Have guys who can step up and next man up.
And that's what good teams have got to do, you know, because everybody battles them this time of year.
Absolutely. Well, you mentioned the bye week. You guys do not have an opponent this week. That'll help on the injury side and some other sides, I'm sure, as well.
I challenged our guys today. I said our opponent this week is ourselves. Mm-hmm. You know, we've got to just continue. I think our guys have done a wonderful job of responding to me and the coaches, Ryan, this year, and just got to continue to respond. We got to continue to develop. A bye week's a little bit touchy because you want to rest,
right?
But you want to work, if that makes sense, because you want to continue to develop. So somewhere in the middle is you gotta keep working. You gotta keep, you know, developing some of the younger guys, developing some of the backups. But at the same time, you want to make sure you're getting some guys healthy and a little bit fresher, because we've got a good month stretch left against some really good quality opponents.
You and I were talking, we talk about this all the time, but you know, you guys have been at it forever. You know, you guys have been at it since January. You really haven't had any time off.
It's been about 12 straight weeks of a grind, and that's every day. I know the kids get a day off, but the coaches hadn't had a day off for about 12 weeks, and that's 7 days a week. So it's good for everybody to kind of recharge the battery and take a deep breath, knowing what's ahead. We got a tough road to hoe still. Got a lot of room to improve, and looking forward to it.
And of course, you guys have some time to yourselves, but also you're working too. I mean, and you're looking at some Friday night lights. You guys are making some trips all over, right?
Yeah, we're recruiting. We're doing other things. We're writing letters. We're making calls. We're doing what you got to do to try to build a program. And you know, I'm power washing the sidewalk out back and cleaning some other things up and doing stuff, that kind of stuff. So it's more than just coaching football,
right.
Especially at PC, you
exactly.
know. But
exactly.
We enjoy it, and we're looking forward to having a open date and then picking things back up.
So after, you know, you have the Big South Conference opener, probably a good time to catch your breath. Is that accurate?
It is. As disappointing as it was, I think there are a lot of things still to, you know, that went positive for us in that game that we can build on, and knowing that there's a fine line between, you know, winning and losing a game like that. We've got to learn from those things, and we can't turn it over three times and expect to beat a good Charleston Southern team.
A game of inches, and you certainly saw it there on Saturday.
Right? No doubt.
Coach, enjoy the bye week. We are done here for your host, Ryan Real, Tommy Spangler. We will see you next time on Inside Blue Hose Football.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. And by Self Regional Healthcare.